Massive number of sessions and the multitude of topics show that it is a complex issue. Looking that we start sharing best practices interventions.
And the poorest 20% has widened continuously over the last three quarters. In the past, people used to focus mostly on the country's growth and export numbers. But things have changed recently. Korean citizens today are much more interested and concerned with employment rate and income distribution indicators than any other macroeconomic indexes. This is a strong signal that the quality of life and the well-being of people are being valued highly. And this trend is parallel to OECD's efforts, including the ladies and gentlemen. It is remarkable that in just a matter of a few decades, Korea has gone from an absolute impoverished country to ranking 12th in GDP and 6th in export around the world. On the other hand, our progress with the quality of life is nowhere near our economic development. For example, in BRI ranking, Korea actively dropped from 24th place in 2012 to the 29th in 2017. To tackle this issue, Korea's new administration initiated a paradigm shift of economic policies that is aligned with the philosophy of OECD's BRI. One of the key pillars of the economic policy direction is inclusive growth. It aims to address